Hi guys, so today I will show you how I change my settings for my camera. So I'm using the Canon N50. Okay, so here's my Canon M50. I am using the 10-22 f3.5 to f4.5, so with the VND filter. Okay, so first we take a look of the screen. I disabled the function button on screen, so if ever I'm using a leash, and it won't automatically change the settings. So I disabled it using this button, the info button, so I cannot touch all the settings, only that the focus touch screen. I will show you later how you change each of these settings on the menu. By the way, we are in the manual dial. If I change it to video, it change the screen function also. What I don't like about this camera, it doesn't have the custom one, custom two option, but the manual and the movie feature doesn't affect each other, so it's a plus also. So we go to the movie option, so you can see there are few settings to change. So if you hit Q set, the only available option is the autofocus, frame rates, white balance, custom profiles, and the other two that I don't change. And if you change it to manual photo, it has two other options, which is the drive mode, metering mode, and the RAW or JPEG option. So let's go back to video mode. So I change autofocus to face detect. In photo mode, it has eye detect, but in video only face detection. So for frame rates, I use 24 frames per second, but it only uses the IPB, not the all eye function. I don't see much difference, so it doesn't matter. For white balance, I use auto, but in some scenarios I use the Kelvin and manually change the white balance. I also use the function, the left arrow or the right arrow, to automatically select the white balance, and I will show you later how I set that custom. For profile style, I am using the Cine Style. You can download this for free on the Technicolor website, and I only change the sharpness into 2 stops, I think, and leave others default. I also change the neutral settings and change also the sharpness to 2 stops and contrast to 0. Yeah, and the other two I don't really bother to change it. So yeah, so in AF mode I'm using the face detect, but if you use this button, it will hold the autofocus, but it will just focus on the things that you focused. Yeah, so I will show you later how to change this custom dial. In photo mode, the record button here, I changed this to stop touch shutter and turn on shutter. But if you change it to video, this is a record button, also on the custom manual dial. So on the exposure settings, so you can see I am using 50 shutter. So the shutter on the video is fixed because I am using the 24 frames per second. So if you're using 24 frames, you just double it for the shutter. So 24 times 2 is 48. So the only available shutter on Canon is 40 and 50. So I use 50 shutter, and I will not change it all throughout the video. So if you're using the manual photo mode, you can change your shutter, whatever shutter you like, but if you go back to the video mode, my shutter stays as 50. So this is what I like about this mode, because it doesn't affect each modes. The exposure button, I use it for changing the aperture to shutter. And the ISO is on the top of the camera using the manual function button. So if I click this, I can change my shutter, my ISO, I mean, using this dial. Okay, so that's the on-screen settings. So let's go to the menu settings. So let's go to the important settings that I use. So let's skip the others and go to the sound settings. So in sound, I'm using manual settings. So it is located in the first option, tab number one. So manual, change it to manual. And the level, I change it to whatever. It depends on the microphone you're using, but mostly I am using between 10 to 12 dB. So we just adjust it and constantly speak on the microphone so you can see what levels or dB are you in. So around there. So if I speak louder, it will not clip. Set OK. Wind filter, just turn it off, and attenuator, turn it off because I'm using a microphone. Now I'm using the lav mic, but in vlogging I'm using the Rode micro. So okay, so that's microphone. Okay, so you call this the touch method. In some cameras there are joystick or arrow buttons to change your focus point. In this camera, the M50 doesn't have any joysticks or custom arrows, so they made the screen as your touchpad. So to change it, just go to the first mode, fourth tab, then go to touch and drag AF. So click it, enable. Then I use the absolute. So wherever your thumb is, the focus point is on that area also. But it's just fixed on the right part of the screen. So position method is absolute, and active touch area is right. So you can choose whatever you want, but for me it works on the right button. Sometimes I use the right top, so if I go down, I can still change settings and touch on the top of the screen. Only available if you're using the viewfinder. If you do this, then you use the touch screen as your joystick. Okay, next, IS. So IS depends on what lens you are using. In this lens, the 10-22 3.5 to 4.5 doesn't have a stabilizer, so I have to use the normal stabilizer on this camera. So you go to the first option, fifth tab, then go to IS settings. So IS settings, enable. I don't use the enhance because it's too cropped and you're just wasting some of the areas of your sensor. So sometimes I use the auto level, it's just using the X axis, but in IS it's using the X and Y axis. It's not very stable, but it's watchable. Function button. Let's go back to the screen. In video mode, you're using AF servo, so whatever you focus and moves, it follows whatever until you use the stop button I showed you earlier. If you want to capture a photo, I change the shutter button into one stop. So it is servo during live mode, but when I capture a scene or a photo, it changed to one stop. So you go to the first mode and the fifth option, go to button function or BTN function. If you use the half press, it changed to one shot AF. If you want the servo mode, you can use that. That's for video option. If you change it to manual photo, you can set it to one shot and half press will be servo or something. So that's for the first mode. Okay, let's go to settings, the main setting of this camera. I leave everything as default except to the video system. So we're using NTSC, so that will give you 24 to 60 frames per second. But if you're using PAL, it uses 25, 50 or something. So NTSC, so for general use only. For shooting display, go to the settings, then the fourth option, shooting display, then screen info settings. So this is how you can choose to turn off all the on-screen displays, like the frame rates and the exposure settings. I chose first one as default, so you cannot touch any buttons except you click the Q set, then it will enable some function, not all. So I turned off third, so it will not enable the touch buttons. And fourth, so we can disable all the display buttons. And fifth, so I can see what setting I set before shooting. If you go to the on screen, click info to shuffle what screen you prefer. Okay, let's go back to the menu. Let's go to the fifth tab on the custom function and choose the fifth sequence. So in this, my first button, this one, it's a AF off. So that's it's using the AF, but if I click this, it will stop, but it still traps the subject. The MFN is ISO as default. Then the exposure, this one is for the changing it to shutter and AF mode. For autofocus and manual focus button, I choose the servo to one shot. If I click this, it changes to one shot to servo. So the flash button, I don't use flash, so I change it to white balance. So if I click this, I can cycle what white balance I want to use. For the recycle bin, I use it for the custom profile style. So if I click this, I cycle through the custom profiles I want. I don't use the delete, so the rules on camera is don't delete anything. So in manual photo, the custom function changes. So go to branch, fifth tab, custom function, then you can see there's a lot buttons to change. So on the fifth option, click Q, I change the button to AF. So if I half press, it changes it to one shot or servo or anything. For this button, it's the same as the video style. It stops the focus, but still tracks the subject. MFN, still ISO, but for the record button, change it to touch disabled. So you can use the screen to take pictures, or turn it off so you can use the shutter button to take pictures. And leave others as default, same as the video settings. So that's all the buttons I need to change, but for the others, depends on you and what settings you use. The more you use your camera, the more things you notice, and the more settings you change that suits your need. But for me, it's just that it's very simple, so it makes my job more faster, quicker. So if you like this video, guys, if you have some other features that you want to change, leave it in the comments. Subscribe, like.